Hello, my name is Leah Smith. I'm an educator here at Glencairn Museum. Glencairn Museum was once the home of Raymond and Mildred Pitcairn and their 9 children. The room that we're in today was once the bedroom of one of those children, and in the 1980s it was converted to become the Ancient Near East Gallery. Today we're going to be talking about ancient Mesopotamia. Ancient Mesopotamia was located in a part of the world that's between the Tigris and Euphrates rivers, what is today modern-day Iraq. The word Mesopotamia comes from the Greek, meaning between two rivers. The people who lived in this part of the world were polytheistic. That's a very big word that means that they worshipped many gods. And these people built beautiful temples and beautiful artwork to please their gods. So let's look at the two reliefs that I'm standing between. A relief is a kind of artwork that's made from carving an image out of a flat object to create a picture. Look at these images. What do you see? What do you notice? Can you mimic the position of the figure in the relief? These images were known to the people of the ancient Near East as apkallu, what we today might call a genie. So when I say the word genie, what do you imagine? What do you think about? Do you think about an all-powerful being that can give you 3 wishes? Well, if we look at these figures, we see that these figures are human. Let's first look at this image. This human-like figure has things that show that he's more than human, that he's superhuman. What you see on the back is 2 large bird-like wings. That's supernatural, right? And then also, both figures are wearing a horned headdress. Those horns on that helmet show that this is a supernatural figure. The artist who made this relief also focused on the strength of the apkallu. Look at the forearms and the calves of this figure. They're incredibly muscular. Both of these reliefs were originally in the palace of a Neo-Assyrian king named Assur-nazir-pal II. He built a huge and elaborate palace and lined the rooms of his palace with these amazing images of apkallu as well as other scenes. His intention was to surround the walls of his palace with over 200 of these figures that would provide him with protection. Their supernatural powers would give him the ability to be protected from the evil caused by humans or other supernatural beings that wished him harm. What's interesting to note about both of these reliefs is that there's no color on them. They are just the color of the natural stone that they were made from. Can you imagine what this would look like if it was brightly colored as it was when they were first made? Can you imagine living in a palace with these brightly colored images all around you? Now, by observing these images, we're learning a little bit more about the people of ancient Mesopotamia. By looking at these objects and thinking about why they were made and where they were displayed, we're learning more about what was important to these ancient people. They cared about protecting themselves and their family from harm, just as people do today. So I want to thank you for joining me today on our mini tour of the Ancient Near East Gallery. And I hope that soon you'll come and visit and learn more about ancient cultures at Glencairn Museum.